So today, as I mentioned, we're going to do yoga. And we're going to do yoga with darling Victoria, who's been teaching me for, how long have we been doing it now?
Oh, more than a year.
We do do more than a year.
I know.
It's amazing. Every
September 2020 we started. Yeah, I know.
Timings. It's gone like really I felt 6 months, yeah. What's good, Victoria, is I felt it was 6 months. I did.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because that's good to me. Because I'm not feeling, oh.
We have had breaks with lockdowns and things, haven't we?
But I think yoga can be very, well, for me, because Victoria's phenomenal. It's like yoga. You know, it's like, that was my feeling around yoga. And so I'll do Pilates, but I'm yoga. And now I'm yoga.
Because I know you want to get strong, Trinny, and this is what this is the type of yoga that we do, which is a vinyasa flow or rocket yoga. It's about getting strong, getting a bigger breath. It's not about making fancy shapes. It's all about just feeling strong inside, getting a really big breath. And really getting into those kind of nooks and crannies that we all have through being on a computer or just our daily habits. It's stretching, opening, breathing. That's all we're doing. Moving and breathing.
Moving and breathing. Moving and breathing. Are we excited to do it now? So what you need, Victoria, I know that we've got a few things here, but if they're starting for the first time and they don't have a block, is it good to have a couple of deep books?
Yes, as long as they're nice and stable. It's basically what blocks do. I'll show you.
Yeah, this is good little technical things. I will be saving this, yes, and it will be on the... You'll have to... I'll save it on the main feed, but then I'll remove it from the main feed when Closet Confessions goes up at 10, but it will be under exercise on my videos with the play button at the top of the grid.
So what blocks do is basically they... when you're reaching down like that... They bring the floor closer to you, so you know they help extend your arms. Yes, so you probably couldn't use books for that, but you'd probably just bend your knee to reach to the floor. Really, it's just we're not kind of muscling ourselves into pose. We're just going to where it feels good, and that's the really important thing. We want to feel good. This isn't boot camp. We're just moving and breathing. And I liken it to a massage. You know when the massage a therapist gets their thumbs into your back. And you go, oh, that feels really good. That's the space where we want to go. We don't want to go to the space where it's like, ow, stop it. It's the, ooh, sort of...
That feels really good. I'm loving this. You're describing it so well. Two house breaks we could do. These are actually yoga breaks, ladies.
Yeah.
But somebody said, I love it. You're not trying to make us go into clever shapes.
No, it's not about shapes. Mm. I mean, that's the misconception about yoga. Is because it can look quite fancy. It's not about the shapes. It's about, we use the shapes to stretch and move our body in all the directions that it did naturally when we were children. So we're just getting back our natural movement and our natural breath.
Love that so much. So I have bad knees, it's easy to adapt. I don't have great knees. So I think when you feel a part of your body is hurting more than it should,
it shouldn't hurt. So definitely back off. Some people say to me, what should I be feeling? It feels different for everybody. Everybody has a different body. We have different habits. So what I would say is just breathe. Breathe deeply in and out. That puts you in the present, in your body, and that should tell you where you're feeling it. If you're feeling any pain, any kind of jabbing pain, back off. That's not a good sign. We want to feel good. It might be slightly uncomfortable good, but think of that.
Think of the deep massage. And the other thing I know is that when I'm doing something and I think it's painful, I realise I haven't been breathing. So it's like, it reminds me, actually, Trinny, breathe. So that thing you were saying, Victoria, it's like breathing, I always forget. I have lower back issues, what can help? So I'd say, you know, lower back issues for me is a lot of, I need to be mobile. I need to move. When my lower back hurts more and more, I'm freezing that pain and I'm not getting circulation to it as well. So it depends on the lower back pain, but I think you can gently do it.
If we're doing forward bends, we will do a lot. If you have lower back issues, you keep your knees bent. Because what we don't want is this sort of bulging feeling. So just keep your knees bent to protect your lower back. And just be a little bit careful on the twist. Just go easy or stay put, don't twist.
And we haven't lost Natalie. Natalie is Monday, Wednesday, Friday with us. And she does her own class at 9:30 on a Saturday, which is why I'm doing this at 8, so that if you want to do both, you can do yoga with us and then you can move on to Natalie. So that's somebody who's really thinking January is a month, I'm changing everything. So should we get started? And it's going to be about an hour. All right, great. Let's do it.
Brilliant, Trinny. So I know we want to get strong, so let's get on the mat. If you have blocks and a strap, any kind of belt will do. Grab them. You might also want a cushion. Sometimes we just want to give a little bit of height under our bum when we're sitting down. It just helps folding forward. So are we ready? Let's start on our hands and knees. Spread your hands nice and broad. Every inch of your hand or index finger, knuckle, your thumbs on the floor. Line your wrist creases up with the front of the mat. The knees are under your hips, and we're just going to wake up the spine, dropping the belly. Inhale, look forward, breathe in. Exhale, round the back, breathe out, glue your navel to your spine. Cat, cow, inhale. Look forward, so we're just warming up the spine. It's our central nervous system. Exhale. Really gently, just moving and breathing. So you don't have to do any of the movements we're doing today. You can just, if you just move, if you just breathe in and out for an hour, we'll call it a win. Big breath in. Exhale out. Inhale in. Exhale out. Come back to neutral. Now we're just going to warm up the wrists and the knees and the hips a little bit, taking big circles. Doesn't have to look like anything in particular. You're just moving these ball and socket joints at the hips and the shoulders, getting some lubrication into them. Very nice. One way, and then the other. And from here, we're going to tuck our toes, draw the belly in, keep the knees nice and bent for this first one. I'll move forward a bit so you can see me. Lift the hips. This is downward facing dog. If you've done yoga before, you'll have done this 100 times. If it's your first time, keep your knees bent a lot. We're working on straightening the back. Big breath in. Long, slow breath out through the nose. So in yoga, we breathe through the nose where we can. Straight elbows. Very nice, everyone. Inhale, come forward to plank. So you're bringing your shoulders over your wrists. Exhale, lower the knees, bending the elbows, belly, chest to the floor. Point the toes. Inhale, lift the heart so your navel is on the floor. Feel the lower back getting stronger. Exhale, chin down. Now lift your belly up, straighten your arms. Tuck toes back in that downward facing dog, opening out the backs of the legs. This time you might want to pedal out your feet. How's that feeling, Trinny?
That's feeling good. Oh. Feeling really good, just stretching everything that was stiff in bed.
It's morning here, so you kind of feel everything when you practice in the morning, don't you?
Yeah, I feel a bit more. I can run up and down the stairs a few times before we start.
Inhale, come back to plank. Exhale, lower the knees, bend the elbows, bend the chest to the floor. Inhale, lift the heart, and this time we're just going to hover the arms off, hover the palms off, so you feel the lower back getting stronger. This is what we want to work. We're doing these cobras here. Exhale, hands down, belly lifts, arms straight. Press back down, we're facing dog. So each time you do a downward facing dog, it starts to feel slightly more comfortable. We're opening a bit more. This time raise the right leg to the sky, the three-legged dog. Bend the knee off centre and open out the hips to the right so the shoulders stay facing the floor. And take that right foot, step it outside the right hand. Just give it a shove if you need a little bit of extra help. And with the back knee down, I'm just going to take some circles, getting into that hip a little bit more. Hips can get really tight, especially if you sit a lot. So just kind of free form movement, going to where it feels juicy, going to where it feels good for you. Doesn't have to look like anything special. Good, you're getting warm. That's a good sign. Tuck the toes. You're going to swing that up and back, three-legged dog. Once again, exhale, take it down. Inhale, plank. Exhale, lower the knees, bend the elbows. Go all the way to the floor, slowly. Inhale, lift the heart. Feel that lower back working like we did before. Exhale, chin down, belly lifts. Push back, down, facing dog. Other side, left leg lifts. Take it off centre. Bend the knee, point the toe. How's your breathing? Big breath in. And as you exhale, step it outside the left hand this time, back knee down. Big circles, just getting into the hip in any way you can. So remember, this is a kind of ball and, well, it is a ball and socket joint. So we want to give it its kind of natural range of motion. When do we ever do that? Hands down, tuck the back toe, swing it up and back once more. Exhale, take it down, you're backing down, facing dog. And from here, we're just going to bend the knees, walk the hands to the back of the mat, feet parallel, about hip width apart, you can see me there, and just hang in a ragdoll. You might want to grab your elbows. And here, especially lower back people, like Trinny's doing, bend the knees a lot so there's no pressure on the back.
Big breath in through the nose. Big breath out. Now take your hands anywhere to the backs of your legs, calves, or higher up. And you want to bend your knees a lot, just so that your upper body tries to make contact with the tops of your legs. Relax the head, and then gently work the legs a little bit straighter. If you want to work on touching your toes, I know that's something that people like to be able to do in life, this is a really good way of opening out the hamstrings. Feels nice and gentle. Starting to feel really juicy now. Release the hands, walk them back out to downward facing dog. Inhale, come forward to plank. Exhale, lower the knees. This time we're only going to bend the elbows halfway. And then we're going to inhale, lift the heart, straighten the arms, take the knees off, roll the shoulders back. If this is putting pressure on your back, keep the knees down. Tuck the chin, lift the hips, down facing dog. Pedaling out the feet, pressing one heel down, then the other, really opening out the backs of the legs. Look forward, now walk your hands to the back of the mat like we just did. And this time, interlock the fingers behind you. Take the arms up and over. Relax the head. Relax, relax, relax. So here we're lifting the shoulders, lifting the fists, we're lifting the belly, pressing down with the feet. Really lovely shoulder opener. Relax the head. Very nice. Release the hands. Let them drop down. Shake out the wrists. Walk it back. We're back in downward facing dog. Bend the knees, look forward, make your way to the front of the mat, so step between your hands, look up, flat back, fingertips on the floor, exhale, fold, look at your belly button, pressing into the feet, come all the way up, hands overhead, look at your thumbs, hands down in front of the heart. How are we doing?
Doing good.
Getting warm? Okay, yeah. So we're going to do a couple of sun salutations, which is warming up the breath, warming up the body, before we go into our standing poses. So, stand with your big toes touching your heels slightly apart. Draw the kneecaps up and drop the tailbone down. Breathing in, breathing out. So there are two things, whatever shapes you do, it doesn't really matter. I'd love you to do throughout the practice. One is we're just gonna lift the muscles of the pelvic floor, gently engage what we call Mula Bandha, and draw the navel in. So this is our inner strength, our lifting against gravity. We're gonna keep this lower back core area nice and strong. So we're gonna keep that pelvic floor lifted, navel drawn in. You should already feel a lot stronger here in the pelvic region.
No, it's a simple thing. When you breathe in, are you pushing your stomach out? And when you breathe out, are you drawing it in or nothing?
No. Well, when you breathe in, you're making an ocean sound with your breath. And I'll tell you how to do that. Maybe just gently engage the abdomen. And as you breathe in, you feel the breath rise into the chest. As you breathe out, you'll feel it sink down. So what I'd love you to do is breathe in through the nose and make a sound like you're whispering on the exhale. Breathe in. Breathe in. And this time, close your mouth, make that same ha sound. Breathe in. Breathe out, ha sound, mouth closed. Now breathe in with that ha sound too. And out. So this is the yoga breath, ocean breath, ujjayi breath. It makes this lovely ocean sound, very soothing for the nervous system. Very meditative, and gives a lovely rhythm to our practice. So there's only two things we have to do, engage your pelvis and breathe. If you're new to yoga, you can skip any of the moves, just keep breathing. You ready? Sun salutation A. Inhale, raise the arms up, big breath and sound. Exhale, fall forward through bent knees, relax the head. Inhale, look up. Exhale, step to the back of the mat, we're in plank again. Exhale, lower the knees and bend the elbows halfway. Inhale, lift the heart, knees on or off the floor, shoulders roll back for the lower back working. Exhale, drawing from the belly, tucking toes down, facing dog. We're going to stay here for 5 breaths. So if you still want to keep the knees bent, please do. We want to really straighten the back, straighten the arms, hands spread nice and broad. Big breath in with sound. Breath out. We're here for 5 breaths. Let's call that 4. Exhale, 5. Soften your knees, look forward, inhale, step to the front of the mat, look up. Exhale, fold. Pressing into the feet, come all the way up. Big breath in with sound. Look at your thumbs. Exhale, hands down in front of your
chest. One more like that. Inhale. Exhale, fold.
Put your belly. Inhale, flat back, look forward. Exhale, step into the back of the mat. And lower into your push-up. So you can, if you know this push-up, you can do it without the knees. We're working on building arm strength. Inhale, look up. Exhale, downward facing dog. Another five breaths. So you want to sink your heels towards the mat, lifting the kneecaps, tilting the pelvis towards the back of the mat. And really press your palms down. Every single inch of your palm presses down. And Trini's learned to relax the head now. Really take the weight off the mind. You can nod your head yes. Shake it out no. Inhale deeply. And exhale. Oh. Oh, I hit TV to relax the face just before your close up. Drop your knees, look forward, make your way to the front of the mat, hop, jump, step, walk. Exhale, fold. Inhale, float the arms up, big breath in with sound. Exhale, hands down. Sun salutation B now, working a little bit faster. Sink the hips low like you're sitting in a chair, arms come. Exhale, fold forward. We're in that forward bend once more. Look at the belly. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, step it to the back of the mat. You're in plank again. Exhale, lower the knees, belly, chest to the floor. Just take a gentle cobra on this one. Inhale, lift the heart. Remember, it's your back working. Exhale, hands down. Downward facing dog, lifting the hips. Feeling a little bit warmer now. Building the heat. Warming up the breath. Inhale, the right leg comes to the sky, like we just did. Exhale, this time it's steps between your hands. Squeeze. You can take the back knee down if you need a bit more stability here. Squeeze the thighs towards each other and see if you can come up to standing. Raise the arms up. Lift the heart. Look up if you can. Tricky bones. Exhale, hands down. Inhale, step back to plank. Exhale, lower into whatever push-up you like. Inhale, lift the heart, so you're in cobra or upward facing dog, this one. Exhale, lift the hips downward facing dog. Same on the other side, the left leg lifts. Exhale, step it forward through the hands. Squeeze the thighs, looking forward as you come all the way up, raise the arms up. Exhale, hands down. Inhale, plank. Exhale, lower into your push-up. You can come all the way to the floor. Inhale. Lift the heart, very nice and pull the shoulders back. That's it. Feel the back working. Exhale. Downward facing dog. Stay here for five breaths. How is your breathing? Breathing with that ocean sound. Palms pressing down. Hips lifting. Head is nice and relaxed. Feeling nice and warm. So we're warming up the big muscles, the arms and the legs, and we're warming up the breath. Big breath in, and big breath out through the nose. Soften the knees, look forward. Make your way to the front of the mat with your feet, hop, jump, step, walk. Exhale, fold. Sink your hips low, we're back in that chair. Exhale, hands in prayer in front of the heart. We're gonna go a little bit faster now. One breath, one movement. Inhale, come into chair. Exhale, fold, look at your belly. Inhale, slide hands at the shins, flat back. Exhale, hands down, step it back to plank. Lower into push-up. Inhale, lift the heart, roll the shoulders back. Elbows squeeze in. Exhale, tuck the chin, lift the belly down, facing dog. Now the right foot steps forward. This time the back heel is gonna come down, so your foot is flat. Coming all the way up, warrior one. Exhale, hands down. Stepping back into plank. Lower into push-up. Remember, you can always use the knees. Inhale, lift the heart, roll the shoulders back so the back is working. And downward facing dog, same on the other side. Left foot steps forward, and then the back heel comes down, so your foot is flat, come all the way up, warrior one, hips face forward. Look up, oh, nice big stretch. Exhale, hands down, you're back in plank. Lower push-up, this is the last one. Inhale, lift the heart. Exhale, downward facing dog, well done. So downward facing dog is now starting to feel like a bit of a rest. It might have felt a bit like, oh, when we first started. Now it's a nice resting pose. Heels stretching towards the mat,
My heels have never touched the mat in 20 years of yoga. It's just the way the angle of my ankle bone is made. It's kind of an obsession with getting your heels down. You do you. Spread the thumbs, index finger knuckle presses down. Big breath in. Oh. Long, slow breath out. Soften the knees. Look forward. Make your way to the front of the mat. Hop, jump, step, walk. Look up. Exhale, fold. Nice breathing, Trinny. I can really hear it. Inhale, sink the hips low, back in the chair. Exhale, hands in prayer in front of the heart. Brilliant.
You got it. I just want to check people are keeping up and feeling good.
Yeah,
I'm doing it. Because it is, you know, it takes time. How are we doing? Morning all, thank you, Trinny, for sharing. Love the breathing part. Good. Go for it, ladies. And if there's things you don't understand or think we would do differently, when I've posted this, will you leave comments like, I didn't understand this or I didn't understand that? That would be really helpful. Yes. It's strenuous if you have a herniated discette. That's true. You could just watch. Anyway,
if you're new to yoga or if you have a specific issue that you're working with, maybe just watch, maybe speak to your practitioner and see if this is the right style of yoga for you. We are doing quite a dynamic, this is a dynamic form, there are lots of different types of yoga, so it's really important to find the right style that works for you. I know getting stronger is your goal.
Yeah, getting
stronger. Okay, I'm standing at the front of the mat. So heel toe your feet apart, we're going to come into a squat. Now, Trinny, I know you like the slightly higher squat because of Trinny's knee, so she's going to go a bit higher. You can go lower, the heels can be on or off the floor. So I'll just show you. So it really doesn't matter. Everyone is working just to open up these inner thighs a little bit more. And coming down. So we're going to work on an arm balance now. You may just want to watch. I'll show you some steps into it. So crow, if you already know crow pose, go right on ahead. Hands nice and flat, arms, fingers nice and broad. We're going to bend our elbows and put the knees on the backs of our arms. If you are newer to this, take them nice and wide. And just work on squeezing the knees into the upper arms. That may be enough. That may be enough for today. If you want to go a little bit further or you're already familiar with this pose, we're going to work on looking forward and just taking one foot off, putting it down.
Are our knees on top of our elbows? Or to the left or to the right.
So I'm squeezing the outer part of my arm with my elbows. With my knees. So here. But you can put the knees on the upper arms like that. I know that's better for your knees. So we're just working forward, transferring the weight into the hands. If you know the full pose and you want to do crow, you can take your feet off. If not, we're working on the squat. We're just shifting the weight into the hands. Very nice. Shake out the wrists. And we're coming back into downward facing dog. As I said, there's no obligation to do any of these poses, just the breathing. Okay, are we ready? Right foot steps forward, the back heel comes down. We're in warrior one, so we're in a standing pose sequence now. Look up. Very nice. Now we're going to open our hips and our arms to the side, warrior two. Arms stretching in opposing directions. So you've done all the hard warming up work now. Inhale, straighten the front leg, step the back foot in a little bit. You're going to reach forward and down. And let your right hand just drop to the shin, wherever it can go, and the left arm comes up. So we're nice and strong. And the legs pressing down with the feet, reaching up with the hand. Very nice. You're going to circle that left arm over. Place the hands outside the front foot, step the back foot in. You might bring your fingertips, might be where you take your blocks. So both legs are straight, pointing towards the front of the mat. So the blocks just bring the floor a little bit closer towards you. I'm going to give you the blocks to anyway. Yeah. And forward fold. So this is pyramid pose, straight legs, or still opening up the backs of the legs. Option to take it into one further pose with a holding triangle. So you've got some. Yeah, okay. So raise the right arm up, twist towards the right. If this is enough for you, stay there. You want it one step further, raise the right hand up. Twisting to the right. Very nice. Exhale, take that hand down. Now we're going to walk the hand, the fingers a little bit further forward, spin off the back heel. Let's see if we can catch some air under that back foot. looking forward. You want to catch some more air under the arms too. You can see if you can bring your hands alongside and fly warrior three, if not, just keep your hands down. We're just playing, just seeing where the body can go, building up strength in that leg. We're going to go back to that warrior two pose, stepping back. So your front heel is lined up with your back in step. Very nice. You're like a piece of toast in a toaster, two-dimensional. And then we're going to take the forearm to the thigh on the right and take the left arm up and over. It's going to come all the way over. Very nice. The little finger side pointing down. Strong back leg. So you're driving through the front foot to press the back foot down. Strong legs. Really nice. This is really strong. Pressing into the feet, come all the way up. You're back in warrior two. Insert the fingers behind the back, lift the heart, look up, and then bow down. Drop the head inside the knee. If this is enough for you, just staying here, stay here. So these moves might be quite new. You might be very familiar with them. Just go to where it feels good. Just to remember, we're trying to feel good. Very nice. Come all the way up. You're back in warrior one. Look up, arms up. And exhale, we're going to take this elbow, left elbow, outside the right knee, hands in prayer. If you want to take your back knee down for a bit more stability, you can. We're taking the twist. So knee on or off, yes, so Trinny's doing the knee down. You want to put your back toe maybe, that might be a bit more stable. Taking the twist. So we're putting the spine through a full range of motion here. Very nice. Okay, hands down. Step it back into plank. Drop the knees to the floor. Sit on your heels, take the knees wide apart in child's pose. So there's an option to rest here, or if you want to work on shoulder strength, which I know we've been working on. So you can stay in child's pose like this, or follow me. Hands flat on the mat. Your elbows are about forearm's length apart. And you're gonna lift your hips, keep looking forward, pressing back through your hands, through your elbows, so you can shift the weight towards the back of the mat. Forearm dog. Very nice. If you want to experiment with lifting one leg off and then the other, if you want to do little hops, you can do that. Strengthening our elbows. And then take it down. Let's all come back into child's pose. Whoo, how is your breathing? Audible breath. Hello. Big breath in. Long, slow breath out. So we're going to do all of that on the other side. Tuck your toes, lift your hips, downward facing dog. And then the left foot steps forward, coming all the way up. Remember warrior one? Lifting the heart, back leg nice and strong. Exhale, warrior two. Arms stretching in opposite directions and lifting up. Remember those, lifting the core, lifting the pelvic floor. Breathing in and out with sound. Inhale, straight the front leg, step the back foot in a little bit, so you have a little bit of a shorter stance. I'm going to reach forward and down, rest your hand on your shin. It's not much weight in here, so basically my legs are doing all the work and the top arm comes up. Look at your top hand. If this is awkward on your neck, you can keep looking down. Breathing in, breathing out. Breathing in, feel like you're pressing something away with your fingertips. Breathing out. Spin the arm up and over. Take the hands outside the foot. Set the back foot in. You may want blocks here. And we're going to fold forward for that pyramid pose that we did on the other side. Option to press the right hand down, left arm up, twist to the left. So you're either in pyramid, on blocks, or you're twisting. Big breath in. Long, slow breath out. Breathing the sound. Very nice. Take that hand down. We're going to walk the fingertips forward and see if we can catch a little bit of air onto that back foot. This might come off an inch, might come off a lot. Look forward if you want to catch some air underneath the hands too. Look forward and balance. Strong back leg. And picture warrior two in your mind's eye. Step it all the way back. We're back in this T shape. Very nice. Left forearm to thigh. Arm comes up and over. So, where should you feel this? It really depends on your body. I feel it all the way down here. Some people might feel it in the hip. Some people might feel it in the back leg. Well, your breath should tell you where you feel it. And remember, we want to feel good. We want to feel that kind of ooh feeling. If you're not feeling that ooh feeling, you might want to go a bit further. If you're feeling a little bit like it's too much, back off. Just back off and breathe. Very nice. And from here, we're going to interlock the fingers behind the back. Take it up and over. Breathing in with sound. And breathing out. Head is nice and heavy. Pressing into the feet, coming all the way up. We're going to take the twist now. So the right elbow outside left knee. You might want to bring your right knee down. Rolling the shoulders back. Look up beyond your top elbow. And very nice. Uncurl. Hands down. Tuck the back toe. You're backing down, facing dog. Boom. Nod your head. Yes. Shake it out. No. Inhale deeply. Exhale. Blubber your lips. Bend your knees. Look towards your hands. We're going to walk the hands to the back of the mat. This is a really nice stretch. I love this one. So you're going to bend your knees a lot. Grab your big toes with your peace fingers. Take your elbows out to the side. And relax. Relax the head and gently work your hips towards the sky. Feel it opening out the backs of the legs and lift your shoulders up too. That's it. Bend your elbows out to the side. So you're using your big toes to pull yourself down. A nice, more restful pose after all those dynamic standing ones. So we're at cruising altitude now. We've done most of the hard work. We're just going to be doing some balancing very shortly. And then we're going to come to the floor. Okay, so another one for all. If you type a lot, this is great for your computer hands. You're going to bend your knees and slide your hands underneath your feet and see if you can stand on your palms, massaging those wrist creases. Padmasana, this is called. Working your legs towards straight. How does that feel, Jenny?
Good.
I know you like this one. All these poses where our head is below our heart is so nice and restful on the head, taking the weight off the mind. Take the hands on the hips. Take a breath there. Stand all the way up. And now see if you can stand on your tiptoes. Squeeze the thighs in towards each other. Pick a spot to look at. Don't move your eyes. Upside down handstand. Who knew? Exhale, come down. Step it out wide. We're just going to do a wide-legged stretch. So my feet are parallel. My toes are almost feel like they're pointing in, but they're actually pointing to the side of the mat. Take the hands on the hips. Squeeze the elbows in. We're going to fold forward. Coming forward to a flattened back might be enough. You could actually even put your hands on a chair or on a table here. If you want to come a little bit further forward and it feels okay on your back, round down, relax the head, walk the hands in line with the feet. So your fingertips are pointing forward. This one, looks like this. That's it. And then you're walking them back and back with the feet. Yeah, that's the one. So you should be feeling, you're probably feeling it here. Yeah. So a stronger stretch for this area. It never really gets a stretch in our daily life. Relax the head. How's your breathing? Breathing in, breathing out. And don't forget, if you have blocks, this is a great place to use your blocks too. Blocks, just bring the floor a little bit closer. Okay. Look up, come up halfway, and take the hands back to the hips. Now we're going to interlock the fingers behind the back like we did before. Lift the shoulders, lift the belly, and take one more forward fold. That's it. Lifting up in the kneecaps, lifting up in the shoulders, press the fists to the sky. Lifting up inside the belly, the pelvic floor, keeping our pelvic floor strong. And release the hands, shake out the wrists. Turn your toes out. You might step it out a little bit wider and bend one knee and then the other. So now we are opening up the inner thigh. My hands are just walking. They're just supporting me as I walk from side to side. That's it. So keeping the bum as low as it will go. Ooh, getting into these hips. So this is a kind of wide-legged shape that we never make. So our poor hips and inner thighs, they never really get a look in our daily movement. So we're just waking them up, getting them back to their natural range of movement. Very nice. Now walk your hands around to the front, drop the back knee down. So I've got my left foot forward. And we're just going to do one more back of the leg stretch here. So my right hip is over my right knee, and my left foot is pointing towards me. And again, it's another nice chance for using the blocks here. And we're going to come into a forward bend of that front leg, stretching out the back knee. If this is tricky on your knee, you might want to slide it back. You can also double fold your mat for extra padding. Forward, really opening out the backs of the legs. If you are a seasoned yogi and you like to go into the full split, don't let me stop you. Inhale, come up. And slowly walk it to the other side. We're just going to do the same on the other side. So move your blocks if you need to. That's it. Take any padding under the knee. Draw the toes towards your face. Hands either side of the leg. That's it. And folding forward, chin towards your shin. Just go to where you can feel an opening in the back of the leg. So you might even be here. Everybody's just feeling the same. It might look different on the outside, but everybody's just feeling the same on the inside. Big breath in. Long, slow breath out. Very nice. And then, very gently, sit down. Make your way to sitting. Sit out with your legs wide. Now, for many of us, we never sit like this, so this might be a little bit pinchy in the hips, so please do sit on a cushion or a block to make that more comfortable. Yes, that step, that's absolutely perfect. Yeah. So we're just using what's around us. That's how these blocks originated, and bolsters. They were just things that were around the house when the Iyengar was practicing as a yoga teacher. Legs out wide. Feet are pointed towards the sky. Take the hands behind you, and you can see this. So these are my fingers like this. Sitting up nice and tall, drawing the feet towards the sky. Very nice. This might be where you're comfortable, breathing in and breathing out. If you want to fold a little bit further forward, some people have a big range of motion here, some people don't. I've kind of got a medium one. Everybody's different, so go to where you feel it. Go to where you feel it doing some good. Very nice. Inhale, come up. We're just going to bend to one side. Side stretch. I do need a lot of stretching here. And the other side. So nice. And come forward. Cross your ankles over. Don't know if you can do that here. We're going to take the hands either side of the hips a little bit in front. Feet on the floor, and you're just going to lift your bum off. Even if it's only in your imagination. Brilliant. Come down.
Wait until she asks you to lift your feet up at the same time.
You can do that. Yeah, bring your knees in. So you want to make yourself into a ball. Look forward, look forward, look forward. And so, yes. Brilliant.
Did you catch that?
Quick, we'll have to screenshot that one. Back into downward facing dog, moving on. And from there, look forward, step to the front of the mat, look up. Exhale, fold. Pressing into the feet, stand all the way up. Exhale, hands down. So ready for our balance poses. I know Trini's been practicing tree a lot, so just remember, balance really is about concentration. It's not so much about can I balance, can't I? So we're really just gonna try and connect with the breath. So we're going to take tree. So again, you can please feel free to take a support, a chair to the side of you if you're just working on this. So everybody pick up the right knee. Standing tall, pressing the left leg down. Pick a spot to look out in front of you. A lower gaze point is much easier than a higher one. My ankle is wobbling a little bit. That's absolutely fine. I'm strengthening the ankle. And then you want to plant your foot either low down with your big toe on the floor or on the inner thigh. Doesn't matter which, we're all doing the same thing. Now take your hands in prayer. You might want to take a support either side. That's absolutely fine. Don't forget, we're lifting up inside. We're breathing the sound. You want to add a little extra? You can raise the arms up. If you're happy here, perfect. You see I'm wobbling, but that's quite normal.
Whoops.
Yay. So falling over is absolutely fine. Crossing the ankle over the knee. And then we're going to sink the hips down. Again, if you want a support in front of you, face it. You can place a fireplace or in the back of a chair. Take the support in front of you. And sinking low into this figure four pose. So it's really great for a runner or a cyclist, stretching out the hips. Pressing into the feet, come all the way up. And shake it out. We're just going to do the same on the other side. Find your breath. Pressing into the right foot now, lift the left knee up. Let's just find our balance. You could even just come onto the tiptoe. That might be your balance today. Taking tree, so either this low version, when you're just putting the big toe on the floor and the heel into the calf, or a slightly higher version, when you're really, I'm strongly pressing my heel into my inner thigh and I'm pulling up this right kneecap to give myself a nice surface to be nice and stable. Hands in prayer in front of your heart, breathing in. Yeah, you'll probably find it's different on each side. Yeah, one side is often harder than the other. Don't forget, you can always, you know, take a support. If you want to add anything extra, you can raise your arms. These are just options. Take your hands down. Cross the ankle over the knee. Again, you might want to turn to face the support here. Sinking low in the hips.
Why can you make your foot more balanced at the bottom? Like,
which
should
foot?
I grab on because I feel my ankles drop.
Which
should
which
I
foot?
My standing foot?
Then that's perfect. That looks good. Sinking down low. Brilliant. Come up standing, shake it out. You'll be pleased to know we're going to the floor now. We're coming into our... Yes. We've done all the hard standing work. We're feeling really warm in our big muscles. We've warmed up the breath. And now we're going to go into some deeper stretches on the floor. So come to the front of the mat. Inhale, arms up. Big breath in. Can you hear your breath? Exhale, fold forward. Ocean breath. Inhale, slide the hands up. Shins flat back. So we're flexing the back in both ways. Exhale, fold forward and down. Step to the back of the mat. You gather in yoga. We don't just sit down. Exhale, knees, belly, chest. Inhale, lift the heart. We're going to take a little hover just to remind ourselves to work the lower back here. Exhale, hands down. Sit on your heels and swing the legs round. So we're going to come into a lovely juicy forward bend now. We're just going to reach for our feet. So you can take a belt. Stretch your legs out. You can take a belt. Any belt will do. I've got a yoga belt here. You can use a dressing gown belt. If you find you're sitting in a rounded way like that, get a cushion or something you can sit on to raise your hips up. It's going to feel a lot more comfortable and you're going to get all the same benefits of the stretch. So some people think that using blocks is cheating. It's not by any means. It really just helps people get into the pose in a really safe way. So sit up tall and reach for the outside edges of your feet, your shins, taking your belt. Inhale, look forward, exhale, forward. So we're looking for a nice flat back here. So it may mean that you're staying at this level, that's absolutely fine. You'll feel the backs of the legs working and you might feel your back stretching too. We want to stay nice and safe. Inhale. So with every inhale, you feel this kind of buoyancy. You feel like the balloon of your lungs is creating space in the body. And with every exhale, we're folding deeper into that space. So inhale. Filling up your lungs like a balloon. Exhale, folding into that space. Inhale, reaching, opening up. Exhale, fold a little deeper. Very nice. Take the belt away. Take off your support if you're sitting on one. Take the hands behind you, fingertips point towards the feet.
feet nice and flat. Come all the way up into tabletop. So press the big toes down strongly. Take the heels a little bit further out. Lift the hips. Lift the hips, press the hands down. If it's comfortable on the neck and you feel happy to take the head back, it's not for everyone, look back. If not, just keeping your chin tucked in. I love this for my shoulders. Tops of my shoulders are really getting a good stretch here. Tabletop. Okay, chin in. You're going to take your bum through your hands. So you're going to come off your toes, stay on your heels, take your bum through your hands, look forward. Come all the way up. If you sit down, no biggie. We've got to start somewhere. Take it forward, strong core work, lifting up the core. One more. Big breath in. And exhale, take it through. Come to seated, lift your heels off. Take your hands alongside the body. This is Navasana boat pose. If you like to extend your legs, do. Lifting from the heart. Imagine someone's got a thread lifting your chest. Big breath in. Nice, Trinny. Put your toes. Yes. Okay, cross the ankles. Hands either side of your feet. You can take the toes on the floor. Lift it up. Working the core. Very nice. And crossing your ankles, roll all the way over. Come to lie on your front. Just going to do a little bit more. Back strengthening, mostly our backs are much weaker than the front of our body. Lie the hands alongside the body, forehead on the floor. Big toes touch or nearly touch if you can. Inhale, lift the head, chest and legs off. Feel like you've got kind of jet streams coming out of your feet and your hands like you're skydiving. Relax your eyebrows. I bet you've got your eyebrows lifted. No.
Yeah, I couldn't. There's so much Botox.
I don't want any more forehead worry lines. Eyebrows are nice and relaxed. Exhale, come all the way down.
Hands on the floor. Make a pillow with your hands. Rock your hips from side to side.
We're going to take the hands in that clasp that we've done a few times now. Lift everything off. Really strong legs. Really strong toes. Press your toes away. See if you can spread your toes even. Back of the neck nice and long, looking forward, and then release. Now, you can stay down here and just rock your hips from side to side if you've had enough of this back strengthening, or you can reach for the tops of your feet or your ankles, and we're going to come up once more. So we're going to kick the feet to the sky. So it's actually my legs are doing a lot of the work here. Breathing in, breathing out. Breathing in, breathing out. Oh, very nice. Oh, it's nice when it's over. Make a pillow with your hands. Oh, rock your hips from side to side. Hands either side of the next to the shoulders. Let's press back into child's pose. Coming up, rolling onto your back. We're going to do one final back bend before we come to our pigeon pose, which is one of my favourite relaxing, passive opening poses for the hips. First bridge, feet parallel hip width apart. I'm sure you've done this if you do Trinny's fitness classes, you'll definitely have done bridge. Lifting the hips, interlock the fingers underneath, squeeze the glutes together, rolling the shoulders underneath, lifting the chin slightly off the chest. Press those big toes down, like you're trying to press the mat away, like you're trying to push it down underneath the floor. Breathing in. Breathing out, breathing the sand. Ocean breath, breathing in, breathing out. If you know the full back bend and you already do yoga, that's in your practice, don't let me stop you. And come all the way down. Oh, let's just raise our arms and legs to the sky, circling the ankles and the wrists. And then big circles, kind of dying fly type thing. Just opening out those joints once more. Pipe the knees in and rocking up and back. Massaging the spine. Oh, feels good. Very nice. Take the soles of the feet together. Again, if you are sitting back like that, put some cushions under your bum.
or some blocks. Open out the feet like a book, sit feet like a book, sit tall. Take the knees out, you can even flap your knees, so opening them out like a butterfly. Yeah, very nice. Trinny's sitting on a block, perfect. So the reason she's doing that is so she can keep her spine nice and long and protect her back. So we're not doing any kind of bulging here.
I think the longer your back, sometimes the more you need it.
Yeah, you've got a long back.
Yeah, I have a long back, so I just can have a tendency to curl forward.
Yeah. And with a straight back, fold forward. And then now you can round the back to relax the head. This is cobbler's pose. Or Bodhisattva. Inhale, come up. We've got one fun thing that we've been working on, so why don't we do it? Round the big toes, and we're just going to lift the feet up. You can just watch this bit if you like. And then we're going to work the legs towards straight. They might come to here. This is core. We stretched out the backs of these legs. Yes, look at that. Very nice. Cross the ankles, hands just in front of your hips. Lift it up. The feet can stay on or off the floor. Very nice, nearly done. Rolling over. Coming into our pigeon as promised now. From downward facing dog, lift the right leg up. And then you're going to take the right knee just outside in front of the right wrist. And then sink down. So what we don't want to be doing is sitting on that right butt cheek. So if you are rolling over, stick something underneath it. Your hips nice and level. And then we're just going to walk the hands down. Now, if this is really not nice on your knees, you can do this on your back. So you're just going to lie down and draw the knee in like this. Or even cross the ankle of the knee like that. You're still getting the same hip opening. So if you don't like being on your knees, try this one. If you're happy on your knees, you do what Trinny's doing, pigeon pose. And back. So really here the floor is feeling nice and close. You're sinking into gravity, feeling nice and heavy on the floor. Taking the weight off the mind. Shoulders relaxed. Very slowly inhale, come up. Hold the hands up. I'm going to swing that back leg, the left one, it's going to swing all the way around. So I'm now sitting down on the right button. The left foot is going to come outside the right knee. Take a twist, inhale the right arm up, exhale, you're either going to hug the knee or elbow to knee, looking over your left shoulder, that's it. So we're going to inhale, lift, remember this lovely tall spine, exhale, look in the direction you want to go, inhale, lift, so you're either just hugging, feeling the twist, or elbow outside the knee. Inhale, come back to centre, and we're just going to roll over, back into downward facing dog to do pigeon on the other side. Oh, I love this fluttering your lips thing. So relaxing, inhale the left leg to sky, exhale left knee just behind that left wrist, and walking the right leg back. Don't forget to put some padding under your bum cheek if you're rolling over. Inhale, lift the heart, fall forward, relax the head. So your head can come onto your hands, it can even come onto a block, or two blocks. But ideally you want your head resting on something, just so that you can feel nice and relaxed. You're really not doing any work here. You're letting gravity do all the work to open up this hip, to relax the mind. Keep connecting with that ujjayi breath, that ocean sound, breathing in and out through the nose with this kind of whispering sound at the back of the throat. Gives this lovely soothing meditative quality to the breath and keeps our minds nice and calm. Don't forget, the pigeon is a little tricky on your back.
It's almost like when I hear you kind of mewing sounds, it's like thinking this is so painful.
Oh, if it's
just on my, I think, because I can't stretch into it yet. I feel my knee hurts, my head, you know, it's like that,
I would say if it's hurting me in any way, it's not feeling good, I would back off slightly, just come out of the pose and breathe. Find the point at which it's feeling like it may be slightly out of your comfort zone, but you're not feeling any pain in jabbing.
I used to do it, so that memory of my being able to used to do it makes me determined.
Yeah.
I should still be able to do it.
But with the breath, we're doing this really safely, breathing into it very gradually. Your body will open safely and we're going to avoid injury that way. Very nice. Okay, so we were in pigeon on this side. So we're going to come up and swing this back leg around now. So the right leg is coming outside the left knee for the twist. So you're sitting on both sit bones now. Inhale, left arm up. You're either going to hug or elbow outside knee. Yeah, so what Trinny said there is really important. You know, just go really gently. Go with your breath. If you think you might be going a little bit far, connect with your breath and just ease off a little bit. You can always go deeper another time. Big breath in, long, slow breath out. Inhale, lifting tall through the spine. Exhale, twist. Uncurls, little derotation to the other side. Lying all the way down. So if shoulder stand is already in your yoga practice and you've learnt it from a teacher, please feel free to do it now. If it's not, if you've no idea what I'm talking about, brilliant, you can skip it. I'm just going to do this nice relaxation pose on our back. So soles of the feet together like we just did. Head on the floor, arms out in cactus.
This I love.
I know, Trinny, you really love this one.
I love it so much.
And you can even, if you have a block, you can even open out the front a little bit more by putting the block, it's kind of sort of lengthways, if you can see that, it's lengthways on the kind of low setting, sort of underneath my shoulders, and my head is on the floor. So if you're in shoulder stand, you're reaching your feet to the sky, squeezing the elbows in a little bit, and when you're ready in shoulder stand, coming through to plow, taking the legs over your head. When you've done a few breaths there, you're rolling out through fish. But this is really nice. This is a kind of cactus opening pose because we don't ever sit with our knees out, our legs out. We don't open up our chest, but yet we spend so much time when we're at our desks, when we're sitting down in chairs, we cross our legs. When we're typing, we're hunching forward, compressing the chest. So this is giving our body the chance to just do the opposite, just keeping its full range of motion. Okay. If you're lying on your back, take the block away. If you've come out through shoulder stand, everybody rocking up and back a little bit. Going to take cosmic egg before we lie down for our final relaxation. Well done, everybody, if you've been working out with us. You're into the home straight now. So sit up tall, hug your knees, hug your shins. You're going to drop the head and you're going to come onto your toes. You can lift the toes so it gives this really nice hovering sense of balancing on your sit bones. Drop the head. If you want to keep your toes down, you can close the eyes. Cosmic egg. Like you're an egg floating around in space, nothing to do, no cares in the world, nowhere to be. Big breath in, long, slow breath out. Breathing in and out with sound. Slowly open your eyes, come up, just sit cross-legged or your shins crossed again, sit up on the height if you find sitting uncomfortable or your knees are high, just place the hands on the backs of your knees, sit tall, long tall spine, closing the eyes. The
listen to the sounds around you. So listen to the sound that's furthest away from you. For us here in London, it's a little bit of traffic at 9 o'clock in the morning. Now listen to the sound that's somewhere in your house or your room or wherever you are. It might be the buzzing of the fridge. It might be other people gently pottering around. And very gently become aware of the sound that's closest to you. It might be your breathing. It might be your heartbeat. And very gently, take the hands behind the back, so I'm just grabbing my elbows. I am keeping my eyes closed, so not just to disturb the peace. I'm bowing down. Very gently come up, lying down for your final relaxation. So this is the point where we take a couple of minutes to lie down. No special breathing, no holding on to anything. So the feet flop out, palms turn up. If you're in a room that's a little bit chilly, you might want to take a jumper or a blanket. You can take an eye pillow like Trinny has, stretching out the legs. If you feel, I'm going to give that to you, so if you feel like lying down pulls on your lower back, put a cushion, a rolled up towel, something like that under your knees. So I'm going to put this there, Trinny, put your, yes, I know you like this bolster under your knees, that releases the lower back a little bit. There we go. So whatever you do, you want to feel really like you're able to let go. So your hands are palms face up alongside the body. Knees flop out, feet flop out. Your eyes are dropping back into your head. The tongue is gently relaxed in your mouth. The root of your tongue is relaxed. Your breath is relaxed and your mind. If you've got time and you can stay here a little longer, please take all the time in the world. If you're ready to come out now, start to move your fingers and toes and maybe rock your head from side to side, keeping your eyes closed. I'm going to stretch the hands overhead. And rolling over onto your right side as if you're getting out of bed. So we're waking up really slowly from this deep relaxation. And very gently pushing into the left hand. Come up to sitting, so sit on a cushion, whatever's comfortable for you to sit tall, cross-legged, or even on a chair. We're gonna close the class with three humming breaths. If you prefer the sound of arm, feel free. Place one hand on your heart, your breastbone.
other hand on top. You can join in with us, or you can just enjoy the sound. Take a deep breath in, humming out through closed lips. Thank you, everybody, who joined in this morning. Thank you, Trinny, for sharing your practice this morning. I hope you enjoyed that. I'm sure if you've got any questions.
We can take questions now if there's stuff you'd like to ask now. And we can just see if there's anything. Victoria, let's sit there. Let's sit there for a second. We'll just see if there's any questions you'd like to ask. There you go, darling. Come on. There we go.
Yeah, how's everyone feeling?
Yeah, how is everyone? you missed it. I will keep this on. What I'll do is I'll put it on the main feed until 10, because then we got closet confessions. But I'll save it under, when you see the play button above the main feed for videos, and it'll be under exercise. One yoga teacher.
Oh, another yoga teacher. That's always lovely. Thank you so much.
So we'll do this. Hi, Jemima. Good morning. We'll do this every Saturday.
Yeah, well, I'm here every Saturday.
Yeah, we'll do it every Saturday. And for those of you who just feel, you know, do leave messages afterwards if you're watching it later as to what you felt about the level of the practice. But I think it was something for everyone. And it's going to be 8 a.m. every Saturday. So have a lovely weekend.
Yeah, that was my kind of yoga. Perfect. Oh, lovely. Yeah, thank you. Great. Thanks, everyone.
All right.
See you again.
Thank you so much. Blue-eyed birdie, good morning. Booth cockapoo, good morning. Yes, lovely, good. Mm. All right, take care. Bye.